Hello everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. Now in this video, we are going to talk about how to deploy your web application on IIS, that is the internet services. Okay, so how are you going to deploy it into the internet information services, that is IIS. Now you know Visual Studio has it inbuilt IIS, and that's what you can see over down here. Now this IIS is for Visual Studio, and that's what it uses to launch applications that we created inside the application, that's inside the Visual Studio. Now in case you want to allow people to access your site, when you launch or when you run the application using the Visual Studio, no one can access it, even when the system is on the internet, it's on the network. But when you put it on the IIS, it becomes very easy for people to have access to your site. And how are you going to do it? How do you deploy it to the local IIS that we have? That is what we're going to take a look today. With this we had it as a project concerning how to develop a multi-vendor application. Now this application allows people to sign in and post their ads as well. Okay, so we are talking about that. You can check the previous videos, you can check videos on that MVC project, and you're going to find this over here. This time around, what you are concentrating on, how do you deploy this into IIS. Now for example, you see I have this open and I have this application source code, and now I can now run this, so Control+F5. Now if I run this here, I'm going to launch that, so you see it's going to be open. So if I open this, if I close the Visual Studio and I'm trying to launch this, it's not going to work. Why am I saying that? Let's try that and see. So we are going to copy this, and then this is a Visual Studio, so we are going to close this project. So let's close this project and now let's run this and see what's going to happen here. So we see that the site can be reached because the server is now shut down. Unless you run the application again, the Visual Studio again, before this is going to work. So at the time before you launch that, you must suppose to open the Visual Studio and launch it there. But you want to, at least when this is off, you can still have access to the application. And that is where you can put it on the network for people to also have access to the same application. So that's what we're going to take a look. The first thing to do here is you have to make sure you have installed IIS on your computer. Now to check that, click on the window key and now let's type in control panel. So control panel, click on that, and now go to programs. So click on turn window feature off and on, and now wait for it to refresh. So let's wait while this is being launched. So while it has refreshed, let's select internet information services. So that is a click on it, and now expand this. We're going to make some few changes here. So expand that. Now expand World Wide Web Services, expand it, check and expand it. Now you can see checked application development features, check common HTTP, so check all this. Okay, when you get to security, let's see, security, check only the request filter. Okay, so check only this for security. And now when you get to performance and features, check the two. Now when you go to health and diagnostic, check only the HTTP login and the tracing, check that. Now when you get to common HTTP features, check all except web dev publishing, so check the rest. And when you get to application development features, open that, check .NET extensibility 4.8, that's the current one I have, check that. Check ASP.NET, that is the 4.8, that's also the ASP version. And now check this three, API filter, extension and filter, and server side includes, so check them. When you're done, click on OK for them to be added to your project. So once you're done that, wait for a feature to be installed. Now right click, click on the window key plus R and type in Annet MGR, hit on the enter key, and you must see that the internet information services manager has opened. So that's an IIS. Now talking about this, you know we have our SQL Management Studio already open and it is actually working now. Okay, so we want to connect to our server and it's been connected already from here. Now the next thing to do here is, we see from this we are actually creating this from the database, so all these data are coming from the database. Okay, so the view that you see here, they are all coming from the database, so we need to actually connect them, and so we can actually deploy it to this, the IIS, even when Visual Studio is not active. So once you have that, you're going to deploy, you're going to publish application. So right, go to Solution Explorer. Now on your project, right click, and now go to publish, click on publish. Now select profile, now go to custom, give it a name. So this is going to be let's give it as what, so sell. Okay, so sell at, so let's make it sell at. So that is the name of our profile, sell at. Let's click on okay. Now while the profile is being created, click on this publish method and now choose file system. Let's choose a location, a target area to store our application. So on our desktop, so it's our desktop, let's create a folder. Let's see, let's go in there and create a folder on the desktop, and on this folder let's name it as, so new folder, sell what at. So that's the name of our project, and now let's go in there and choose the sell at over there. So let's click on cancel. Now let's use file system, let's click on again, so desktop, and now choose sell at, click on open, and now click on what, publish. So we wait for to receive an notification here for it to be published. So let's wait while the publishing is being made. So now it is now published. You see we have build one succeeded and publish one also succeeded. So we are done. We can now save application, and now you can save this application, and now you can close the Visual Studio. Okay, so when you go to our desktop, we have it here at that's a cell ad, right? Now with the cell ad, when you open it, you see we have this content here. But one thing is, I have some images, and for that images I have to actually add it myself. So I'll go to my project root, and now let's see, so that is found in C, and that's the name of my project, ASP.NET project, so 2017. That's a web application 2, and I click on this. So I have this folder, and I have upload folder as well. So I'm going to copy those two folders because I added it myself. So I'm going to go that those two profiles or the folders, and I'm going to open the art. So the output desktop cell art, and I'm going to paste them here. Okay, so I have them here. Now if you open contact content, I suppose you have this. I also added the font awesome, so let's go in there and add it as well. So the folders that you added yourself, you must make sure after publishing you copy and paste those folders, because those folders contain the file that you want or you've been using in your application, and these folders contain the images I have used here. So you wait for this to copy it. After that, you're going to now launch application. So you see that we've closed the Visual Studio. So when I try to refresh this, let's see, if I try to refresh this, I'm going to have an error here. So let's wait. You see I have an error, can't be reached, the same page and but store, I cannot be reached here because the server, it is down now. Now let's wait while it has finished copied. Let's wait for it to finish. All right, so it has finished copied now. Now the next thing to do here is we have to deploy it into the IIS, so we can actually have access to our site again. So open your IIS, and now click on this server, a recent site, right click and go to add website. So website, what is the name? Cell at, that's the name of our site. Now physical path, we choose a physical path, desktop. So that is salad, so cell at, that physical path, click on OK. Then let's see here, let's use a different port together. So let's use port 1048. So that's our port. Now host name, let's leave the host name as blank, Now click on OK. So let's wait. Now our system is, we've added our site to the project, but let's try here and see. So if you pass in localhost /1048, that is our port. Let's see if it's still going to work for us. So let's wait for it to load, then we see what's going to happen here. So you see that it is saying that login field for user IIS. Okay, so that is this pool. Login has failed. So let's go in there and check this and make sure you have the same issue, then you're going to sort it out quick. So localhost, then we can pass in our port as well. But let's see what we can actually do here. Let's try to pass in with this. So let's see if this is going to make possible here. So let's edit. So let's see how to, so manage website, advanced settings. Okay, now here, let's make it this way. First, click on the site now. Now go to bindings. Now the bindings, click on this, and now go to edit. So host name, let's try to sell at. So sell at, let's see if this is gonna work for us. So click on okay. Now close. So restart our server. Now let's try to refresh this. So it is telling us, so let's change this to sell at. So sell at, right? And now let's wait and see what's going to happen. So we see this site can't be reached. Okay, so this site can't be reached, and so let's use the localhost also and see. So localhost, all right. So this is what we're going to do. Let's go in there and the same place, select the website, and I'll go to bindings, and I'll click on this, edit. So let's clear this. Okay, let's clear the host name. Let's add the .com as well. You want to test something to see. So sellad.com/this. Now let's see if actually it's going to work. So how do you have sell ads.com, then we have our port. Okay, so sellad.com/port is still not working. Now let's move on and see what's going to happen next. So let's get back, and now let's clear where sell at. So this is what we're going to do. Clear the host name. Now click on okay. So we have the port here identified, and now click on okay. So it's going to run locally on the localhost as it did initially. So let's replace it with localhost. And now you must have the application pool is denied. So let's go in there and fix that very quick. So to fix it, click on this, go to application pool. Okay, now you see we have the cell at here. So right click and go to advanced settings. And now check here under identity. Let's search for identity. Okay, so identity over here. Now choose this. They're going to choose a local system. Now click on OK. Click on OK. So that is all. Now let's stop this. Let's start it again. So let's see. So you have cell ads over here. Now let's refresh. So let's refresh it. Now application pool. So cell, you can see a local system here. Now that's what we're going to do. Click on site, and now click on application. Now let's go to, it has been restarted already. So let's try to refresh this. That's what's going to happen. So cell at service unavailable. Let's browse from this site. So browse on this HTTP. Now we have service unavailable. So let's see the reason why it is saying service unavailable. Let's stop the server. Now let's go to bindings again. So port, we have edit. So we have an assigned as a port 1048. So cancel. And so this one, let's go in there to application pool. Now let's delete So let's close this tab. We want to start afresh. So let's go in the let's delete this cell here, because you're not going to use that. You're using the cell add. Let's click on that. Now we have this already. So we have it's working already. So we select this. Now you go to bindings. We check also. So there's a port over there and HTTP. So we close it. Now once you're done with this, the next thing to do here is let's run this application and see. So browse this, click on that. Let's what's gonna happen here. So you can see it is now working. You can see we've closed the application, that Visual Studio, but it is now working as well, because we've launched that in the IIS. But one thing is, when you have a problem here, maybe we're gonna have a database problem. But in case that happens, I have a solution for you. Just go to write your management studio. So management studio, right click, and now go to open as administrator. So run as administrator, you wait for it to be open, then we move on to that. All right, so while it is open, let's connect it. So now that's what you're going to do. Go to security and click on security, and now login, click on login. So expand that. Now you see we have NT administrator, that NT authority system. Right click on this and go to properties. Now aside from that, the next thing to do here is click on server roles, and now check public and check system admin. When you're done with that, click on OK and you're good to go. So you're able to launch application with our own specified port. Okay, so we're not using the normal port, but we're using our own port now. So if I copy this, and I can even, if I close this web browser, I can still open the web browser again, and I can have access to the site. So let's see, if I go to guest mode, and if I paste this, so we have a localhost port 1048. So just type in localhost. So localhost. So we are localhost, and we have 1048. That is our port. Click on the enter, and it's going to load to a page now. So you can see our page is now working, and you can put this on a network and have access with our phone as well. Alright, so that is it for this video. I hope this is clear and you've known how to deploy application to the IIS as well. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this is clear, and hopefully I'm going to catch you up in the next video.